Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Kicking off this video, Chris Burgin posted a tweet about another launch agreement with SpaceX to launch some satellites. It says ExoLaunch announces a new multi-launch agreement with SpaceX. The agreement includes more launches, more slots, and more capacity for ExoLaunch to integrate customer satellites on board SpaceX dedicated rideshare missions called Transporter missions during the next 2 years. He then responded with another tweet saying on Transporter 1 and 2, 46 CubeSats were deployed by ExoPods and 13 Microsats were separated by Carbonix's 1500 kilograms of satellite mass. The next SpaceX rideshare mission with satellites integrated by ExoLaunch Transporter 3 is scheduled to launch no earlier than January 2022. Eric Berger posted a tweet saying NASA has assigned Jessica Watkins to the Crew 4 mission set to launch on a Crew Dragon spacecraft in April 2022. She joins NASA astronauts Shel Lindgren and Robert Hines and ESA's Samantha Cristoforetti. Watkins and Hines are the third and fourth class of 2017 astronauts to fly. Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. Here's a view of the orbital launch mount and tower construction progress. SpaceX are removing a berm at the launch site. The progress on the new wide base structure is continuing nicely. Christian Davenport posted a tweet saying the FAA expects to conclude its environmental assessment by December 31, 2021 for the SpaceX Starship Super Heavy launch vehicle program at the SpaceX Boca Chica launch site in Cameron County, Texas, permitting dashboard. Musk responded with, "The hard work by the FAA, US Fish and Wildlife and Texas Parks and Wildlife is much appreciated, as well as the strong local support from Cameron County and Brownsville or South Padre." NASA have posted a bunch of HLS information and Michael Sheets posted a tweet. He said NASA's Inspector General projects the Artemis 1 mission will not launch until summer 2022, while delays on the HLS program and new spacesuit development mean it will be several years later than expected until the agency lands astronauts on the moon. Elon Musk posted an amazing shot of the Raptors on Super Heavy with the caption 12 million pounds of thrust at liftoff. In response, somebody posted a tweet saying, "Can't wait for Raptor 2, it's still a rat's nest up there." Musk responded and said, "True, although it will look clean with closeout panels installed." Raptor 2 has significant improvements in every way, but a complete design overhaul is necessary for the engine that can actually make life multiplanetary. It won't be called Raptor. Teslarati posted a tweet about an article saying SpaceX CEO Elon Musk to discuss Starship at National Academy's meeting. Musk responded with, "Limiting factor for first launch is regulatory approval. Thereafter, fundamental issue is solving engine production. Prototypes are easy, production is hard. There are some nice, smooth Starship nose cones in the fabrication tent. Here's the GSE-4 test tank waiting at the launch site for testing. Starship 20, after some testing recently, was seen moving one of its flaps. The body section of Starship 21 is continuing in the midbay. The nose cone section of Ship 21 is also continuing out in the yard. Crews are working on the heat shield tiles on this nose cone. I'm going to share the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website. There is currently a closure scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 18th, for some possible testing. Then there's also a further closure this week with Friday 19th. As well as that, there are closures for next week with Monday 22nd and Tuesday 23rd. Super Heavy Booster 4 is still waiting at the launch site for testing. Super Heavy Booster 7's upper dome stack is waiting to be sleeved. To finish up today's video, we have the latest Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. As always, I have to thank both Mary or Boca Chica Girl and Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.